No, to be honest, when we got the invitation, we're kind of reluctant to participate because lalo na nandun yung word na design, no? And what we really do in Escuela Talier or in conservation, at least sa perception siguro ng general public, we do very little design, no? We do very little design. But however, when we saw or ako personally, I saw the word better places and then social responsibility. Sabi ko, I think we can share some concepts, some approach and some philosophies in conservation that can be borrowed or adapted by architects or young architects in the present. So yeah, I'll be presenting or I'll be sharing thoughts about the topic, of course, in the context of built heritage conservation. When we talk about or when people hear about built heritage or conservation and then relate it to contemporary architecture or design or the practice of architecture, there seems to be a tension, no? There seems to be a tension or may contradiction, no? Lalo na when you look at conservation about dealing with the past and then versus what we have now, the past versus the future, and then of course yung old versus sa new, no? So those are contradicting ideas or concepts that can relate to conservation of built heritage and the contemporary practice of architecture, no? Maybe that gap or that tension, no, can be best exemplified by these two photos. This is actually the same building, no, similar buildings. Yung nasa left nung buo pa yung film life, this is the film life building, and on the right is what appears to be the dismantling of the same building, most probably to give way to a new development. So this is not a new scene, no, in the conservation realm, so to speak, no? We've seen or we've heard this photobomber, as people called it, no? And what during the discussion, no, the clamor of regarding these issues, no, eh mas na emphasize, I think mas na-emphasize yung gap, no, between the practice of conservation and the practice of contemporary architecture. There appears to be tension, no, because yun na nga, I think ang shallow a perception, if I may say, about built heritage or conservation is it advocates freezing the environment in time. But in fact, it does not advocate freezing the built environment in time because it cannot, as shown in this photo, lagging may stronger force that can tear it down, bring it down, ano, just like what happened in this church in Loon. In Bohol in 2013, when that strong earthquake happened, no. So to really begin, conservation is not an advocate of freezing our built environment in time. So ayaw niyang maging, if I may say, ayaw niyang maging museum, no? Parang museum yung ating built environment, because conservation is more than what can be seen or what is tangible. Conservation or our heritage is my intangible component din yan. In fact, the UNESCO no describes it or can further categorizes a conservation or a heritage in two, no, tangible and intangible. So more than the buildings that we see, the old buildings, the buildings from the past that we see, there are more things, no, that in that encapsulates, no, that particular artifact, so to speak. Conservation deals with the collective human experience, no, of the past, present, and the future. I am showing a project of Escuela Taliel in Batanes, and with this statement, no, ako personally, I've seen the past and the present and the future here, no, the Ivatan houses, no, the vernacular houses of the Ivatans tell about their past, who they are, their society, how they were, how they are now, no, how they are now, you know, the our built environment, no, tells a lot about us, no, parang I think may nabasa din ako dati, your room tells about something about your personality, and for societies it's the same, no, in a larger sense, our built environment, our urban landscape is a reflection of us, no, so somehow the condition of the urban landscape or the streetscape of Batanes, particularly this town in Savidug, the town of Savidug, no, tells a lot about them. And if you want to, if you can project, no, based on what you can observe, no, you can tell somehow about their future, no. So yeah, conservation deals with the collective human experience. I want to emphasize that phrase, no, collective human experience, because in architecture that is really important, because architecture touches lives, touches experience, the human experience. So I think we need to be sensitive with that, and that the sensitivity, no, of professionals, no, working in the built heritage, the conservation of built heritage, may be adapted siguro ng ilang architects if they want to capture that human experience that needs, no, response, no, when we design things, no. So conservation's primary agenda is to maintain the cultural significance of a place, no. Kaya ako nasabi kanina na medyo, I think ang perception ng tao sa conservation is medyo shallow, no. Basta luma, retain na luma yan, ganyan ang itsura niya, no, that is conservation na. But no, mas malalim pa doon, no. The very core of conservation is the subject of cultural significance or cultural value, meaning, no, meaning of a place, no. The conservation's primary agenda is to maintain the cultural significance of a place. What you're looking at now is a session with the community of with the representatives, at least of the community of Santa Ana in Manila. We are discussing with them, no, the renders or the color of that we found doon sa facade ng simbahan ng Santa Ana. And to give you a closer look on what we found this at least three layers of renders or colors, no. Why is this important, no? Because again, sabi ko nga, the built environment, no, particularly itong mga churches or structures natin that have survived decades and centuries, no, they are really valuable, and they've become, no, they somehow the identity of the people living around it. So it's important na ipakilala sa kanila kung sino siya, sino ano itong mga ito. And then again, when we found this evidence, we told them, do you want to be identified with this? Naniniwala, is this something meaningful sa inyo? Although my hard evidence, and then when we showed them, no, na ganyan, medyo they were taken aback. Kahit ako siguro kung ako taga Santa Ana, although hindi ako Catholic, no, parang hindi yata ako papayag na I'd have a pink, no, a combination of yellow and pink church, no. Nakita ko siya na bare stone all my life, and then suddenly makikita ko to. Although truthfully, no, truthfully meron siyang part ng past niya, pagkakaroon ng kulay, no. But more than the color, the render of this church, actually may iba pa eh. So ang what we read from them, from the community, hindi yun yung significant for them, no. What is significant for them is for their church, no, which is a part of their, which has been a part of their community, no, na ma-maintain na nakatayo, no, because madami silang experience, marami silang activities, it played a role in their family's lives, in their own lives, in the life of the community. So basta ang agenda nila doon ay ma-retain yung presence ng church na yon, ng building na yon, and that is significant enough for them. So nakita natin dito na the cultural value of a place is a good resource when dealing with the environment, no. So hindi lang yung actual building, but more of the value, the cultural value, at sino ba yung nagbibigay ng value na to, kundi yung society, the community, hindi lang yung nakatira doon, but those that have lived before us, you know, yung value or yung meaning of a place, hindi naman yan na snap, no. Why I'm telling this is because later on, no, siguro I can expound on this, because meaning is something that an architect cannot readily or instantaneously create, no. It takes time. Value needs time to be consolidated or para mabuo. And yung value na yun, we need to identify that, we need to pinpoint that, and we need to maintain that, we need to safeguard that value if we want to anchor to this value, to stimulate the society to have to provide stability, lalo na pag sa identity of a community or of a locality, lalong-lalo na in this present time na ang daming pressure, urban pressures, nagtatayuan, nagsusulputan ng kung ano-anong buildings or structures dyan, it can disrupt, no, yung ating experience, yung usual experience natin dun sa ating built environment that we have given meaning to and shared with others, no. Parang this church, no, in Malate, very tricky project, because it's the main facade, no, is the last leg of the project, and we were we were really sensitive on what to do with the main facade. Sila gusto nilang ma-retain, no, somehow yung pagka quote unquote pagka luma or yung pagkasira niya. But for us, the agenda is, yeah, you can do that, but sooner or later, if we don't do any intervention, it will crumble down, and yung valuable, no, edifice ng community, no, that's something that you have shared experience with, ay mawawala din. So we made interventions, no, just to arrest deterioration and just clean it up, and then simple, no. very, very straightforward attack doon sa actually hindi problema ng conservation. Actually, this is a question na thrown to the community eh. No, ano ba yung gusto niyo doon sa identifier ng community niyo? So ang maganda doon, we had a good response nakita namin na may pakialam sila doon sa kanilang built environment, and we are, as an architect, I'm happy about it because it makes my job or our job easier when people can interpret can somehow express what they want. So learning from this project, no, yung ibang project din ng Escuela Talier, no, we try to involve the community because most of these, if not all, most of these heritage structures have been are part of the society of the local community, no? For example, this is Paco Park, no? We did some conservation efforts dito, and again, we are happy na may mga nag-participate dito sa activity na to, sa project na to, hindi lang dun sa mga taga Paco, but yung mga nakaalis na sa Paco, dating nakatira doon, yung mga bumibisita sa Paco Park, no? So maraming stakeholders, no? So if we can only, no, if we can only stimulate people to be active, no, to participate, no, if we can only show that these structures, no, have meaning, have significance sa kanilang buhay, no, sa kanilang pamilya, no, most of this minsan siguro dinadaan-daanan lang, pero when you try to present and interpret to them the value of this, at pag na-capture nila yon, no, magkakaroon sila ng pakialam, no, like the clamor again doon sa itatayong building sa likod or near the San Sebastian, no, church dito sa may Quiapo, no, maraming pressures ng local and global change lalo na sa urban transformation, pero again, a good thing that the community here is sensitive, so and the stakeholders are sensitive sa magiging effect ng project behind the basilica, so I think nagkaroon ng intervention, no, doon sa kung matutuloy ba o hindi yung nung project na ito. But again, kala ko ba hindi siya it does not advocate freezing in time, but pinipigilan niyo yung transformation na yun? No, heritage conservation acknowledges change. What conservation wants is to manage these changes to be managed, no? Unavoidable yan eh, yung mga transformations na yan, but we want again to protect, to safeguard the cultural significance na nabuo throughout the generations, and we don't want it lost. Yung receptacle, yung manifestation ng cultural value na yun, the edifice itself, ayaw nating basta-basta siyang mawala or masapawan siya or mawala na lang siya sa urban fabric, and then mawala na rin yung kanyang meaning, yung kanyang value. So from these things, what architects can do? No, learn from the past. Let's learn from the past. Anong ibig sabihin nun, sir? Kakopi ba tayo ng components from the past? No, that's a shallow approach sa conservation. Ay, maglalagay ako ng ganitong component kasi galing ito sa bahay na bato, etc., etc. No, you know, sa conservation, as we do projects, no, nakita ko yung intention nila. Nakita ko yung intention ng designers, yung wants ng community, ng society, no, na capture ng structure yung spirit, no, na protektahan nila throughout time somehow, somehow, and we can also do that. We can learn from what the experience of these communities, no? So we can capture, protect, and enhance the spirit of the place, no? Spirit of the place. And borrowing, lastly, borrowing from the Philippine Heritage Charter as the concepts that we want to emphasize in the Heritage Charter of the Philippines, no? We can also, I think we can also adapt this in designing new communities, designing for communities. Sana maging sensitive tayo in designing how appropriately, no, we design, how responsive, how appropriate, no, doon sa needs yung ating dinidesign, how responsive our, again, sa needs taka sa environment, and how relevant this our design is to the current culture, no? So I think with this at least with these three, no, ideas or concepts, no, we can somehow design better places, and we can be socially responsible, because these ideas, concepts are sensitive, no, sa human experience ng built environment. So I think that's it. If you want to know more about sa projects ng Escuela Talier, you can visit yung Facebook page namin, Escuela Talier de Filipinas Foundation Inc. So thank you.